गुड मॉर्निंग। आई एम प्रोफेसर आदिमूर्ति, फैकल्टी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ऑटोमोबाइल इंजीनियरिंग, बीएलडी एसोसिएशन वचन पितामह, डॉक्टर पीजी हलगट्टी कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, विजयपुर, कर्नाटक। नाउ इन दिस सेशन आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट सिस्टम इन ऑटोमोटिव चासिस एंड सस्पेंशन कॉम्पोनेंट्स, दैट इज सस्पेंशन सिस्टम। Suspension system is one of the very important systems in an automobile. So, in this chapter, the students will be able to understand the functions and advantages of suspension system, various types of suspension system, and in the different types of independent suspension system, leaf springs, coil springs, different types of shock absorbers, air suspension systems, and various components of suspension systems, and also the latest developments in the suspension system. So what is a suspension system? When you observe an automobile, the automobile chassis is mounted on axles, and not directly but through some form of springs. This is done to isolate the vehicle body from the road shocks, which may be in the form of bouncing, pitching, rolling or swaying, and to avoid the additional stresses in the vehicle frame. Basically, the suspension system consists of a spring and a damper. The energy of the road shocks causes the spring to oscillate, and these oscillations are to be restricted to a reasonable level by the damper, which is more commonly called as a shock absorber. Now, when you go through the suspension system's objectives, there are three major objectives for the suspension system, and the main objective of the suspension system is to provide a comfortable ride to the passengers and to avoid the stresses in the system. Second one is to preserve the stability of the vehicle during pitching, rolling, yawing, swaying, etc., because of the variation in the distribution of the loads and also the variation in the road conditions. There are chances for pitching, rolling, yawing, which may destabilize the vehicle. And the one of the important functions of the suspension system is to preserve the stability during these conditions. And also it will help in reducing the unsprung weight of the vehicle. When the vehicle's weight can be broadly called into or classified into sprung weight and unsprung weight. The unsprung weight distributes a lot to the instability of a vehicle. So, with the help of the suspension system, the unsprung weight can be properly controlled. And the basic functions of a suspension system are to prevent the road shocks from being transmitted to the vehicle components, to safeguard the occupants from the road shocks, to reduce the impact stresses on various mechanisms of the vehicle, to preserve the stability of the vehicle, as we already discussed during the pitching, rolling, bouncing, etc. And it also gives the cushioning effect by which the ride will be comfortable. Basically, there are two kinds of suspension systems. First one is the rigid axle suspension system, and the second one is the independent axis suspension system. In this figure, you can see an arrangement which is called as a rigid axle suspension system. You can observe, in this case, we can find an axle which is a rigid and a single piece, and on both sides of the axle, the wheels are communicated or mounted with the help of the spindle and the kingpin. With the help of this arrangement or the stub axle arrangement, these wheels are mounted over this particular single rigid axle, and the vehicle frame is mounted over this rigid axle, and in between the vehicle frame and this axle, we can find the suspension system. Here in this case, it is a leaf spring suspension system. So, and this is one of the conventional suspension system. Basically, two pairs of wheels are mounted on the rigid axle. The chassis is supported and the axle through the springs. Thus, the moments of the wheels when the wheel is passing over the irregularities or which passes over the obstacles, it experiences exactly the same magnitude and angle of moment in the vertical plane. It may be a left one or right one. Whenever it is approaching, a wheel is approaching an obstacle, so the moments will be transferred to the entire axis and entire axle of this rigid axle suspension system. The second kind of suspension system is called as an independent suspension system, where we have earlier observed that the wheels are connected through a rigid axle in case of a rigid axle suspension system, whereas in case of independent suspension system, the chassis is supported on the wheels and the suspension system, and the axle is not rigidly connected, and here the wheels are not connected through the rigid axle. The moments of the two wheels are not interdependent because the chassis is supported on road wheels without using a rigid axle. So the independent suspension system is an arrangement for connecting the road wheels in which rise or fall of one wheel has no direct effect on the other. So whenever we use the independent suspension system, it is having several advantages. So one of the advantages is the system is softer springs can be used without increasing the rolling effect. So whenever we use the softer springs, the ride comfort will be there. And here, unsprung weight is also reduced, which reduces the wear and tear of the tire and increases the tire life. And the wobbling of the vehicle can also be avoided by using the independent suspension system. And the strain per unit spring weight in the coil spring is greater than the semi-elliptic spring, means lighter springs can be used whenever we are using the independent suspension system. And the steering precision will also improve and the wheel moments are not linked. It enables the front suspension to be arranged far enough apart to promote the understeer conditions, which preferably over the oversteer. The engine and chassis frame can be placed relatively lower, resulting in the more space for the passengers. In addition to the advantages, the independent suspension system also got some disadvantages. They are like the faces of a coin. There will be advantages as well as disadvantages for each and every system. And here one of the basic disadvantages is the initial cost is high because the construction of this independent suspension and the number of components in the independent suspension are comparatively higher than the rigid axle suspension system. So initial cost will be high. And steering geometry alignment is critical and requires more frequent attention. If it is a rigid axle suspension system, the problem with the alignment will be less. But in case of independent links or independent suspension system, we need to provide more care and frequent attention is required in case of independent suspension system. And whenever the bouncing is happening, the wheel track causes the tire wear. And more rigid chassis or subframe structure is required because it has to take all the load of this vehicle. And the effect of unbalanced wheel assembly are transmitted to the steering wheel more easily. The wheel cambering with the body roll reduces the cornering power. These are some of the disadvantages of the independent suspension system. There are various kinds of suspension systems. They can be listed as below. One is the wishbone suspension system. Second one is the MacPherson type suspension system. Third one is vertical guide suspension. Fourth one is trailing link suspension. And fifth one is swinging half axle type of suspension system. Even though various types of suspension systems, independent suspensions are available, some of the systems are popular like the wishbone suspension system and MacPherson type suspension systems are more popular types of independent suspension systems used in the automobile. Here in this sketch, we can observe one of the independent type suspension system, that is the wishbone type of suspension system. So this is one view, and this is another view where you can get the details of the arrangement of the arms and the springs and the shock absorber. So you can get more information from this particular figure, and this is for just a line diagram to represent the wishbone type suspension system. Basically, it consists of two wishbone members. One is the upper wishbone member, this one to this point. This is the upper wishbone arm, and this one is the lower wishbone arm. They are also called as upper and lower control arms, and these control arms are connected with the chassis frame. And between the upper arm and the lower arm, you can see a coil spring, and in the coil spring you can also observe the shock absorber. And the ends of these control arms here are communicating with the stub axles on which the wheels are mounted. Left side as well as the right side, the arrangement will be similar. And one thing you can observe here is the upper length of this upper wishbone arm is less than the lower wishbone arm. And between the wishbone arms, the spring or the shock absorber arrangement is provided. The vehicle weight will be transmitted from the body and the cross members through the coil spring, through which goes to the lower wishbone of the member. So this is the lower wishbone. Whatever the load coming over the frame will be first transferred to this member, and then it compresses the spring, and the lower wishbone arm will take the load. The shock absorber is placed in the coil spring, as we have already discussed, and it is attached to the lower wishbone member as well as the upper wishbone member or the upper control arm. From this sketch or diagram, you can compare the dependent or rigid axle suspension system or the independent suspension system. When you consider the rigid axle suspension system, you can see when it is moving on a flat surface, both wheels are at the same level, and you can see the springs are also equally stretched or the stretched, or the stresses are same on both sides. Now you can see in this, whenever this dependent suspension system, one side wheel is passing over the bump, you can see the one wheel is moving in the vertically upward axis. Because of that, whatever the load that is taken by one spring is compressed when you compare with the other spring, and the body will be slightly tilted, and depending upon the level of this road disturbance, there will be rolling effect on the chassis frame, and the rolling chances are more in case of this dependent suspension or the rigid axle suspension system. Because of this reason only, the independent suspension systems are designed where you can see on a flat surface, both wheels are on the same plane, and equally the loads are taken, or equally the load will be distributed on both sides. Now, whenever one wheel passes over a bump, you can see the wheel is moving in the vertical axis, but only this level, only it will be limited to one side of this frame, and with reference to the position of this body, you can see here body is tilted, or rolling is possible in this anti-clockwise direction, but here you can see the body line is parallel to the ground, and rolling effect will be very, very minimum, which is the advantage of this particular independent suspension system. And this is the reason for which most of the cars are provided with this particular independent suspension system. The only basic disadvantage with the independent suspension system, as we have already discussed, is nothing but the cost, number of components, and the complications in the production, and as well as the maintenance. It also influences the steering geometry. If slight damage in the linkages are there, bent in the linkages are there, it is going to change the steering geometry of the vehicle, and frequent maintenance of this steering geometry is required. And overall, maintenance cost of this system, the independent suspension system, will be greater than that of the rigid axle suspension system or the dependent suspension system.